Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be talking about softened edges, how to smooth them, how to unsmooth them, and everything in between. All right, so you can see this fruit bowl here has a bunch of really smooth shapes, and when I double click on them, there's a bunch of hidden edges that are inside of there. You can unsmooth that pretty easily. If I do this, you can see all the lines that make up that geometry. But what I'm going to show you is how you can unsmooth that kind of stuff if you want, but also if you construct a fruit of these kind of lines, how you can then soften them so that they look just like this model. So we're using a sphere today as sort of the inspiration for moving forward. I've constructed this using the Follow Me tool, and I have a video I'll post in the description below if you want to know how to do that. But what we're going to do is we're just going to take this and we're going to copy it off the side. So I'm pressing M here for the Move key or the Move tool, and just then hitting Control to make a copy. What I'm going to do is I'm going to unsoften this so that I see all of those edges. So I just want to soften edges. If you don't have this tray open, you want to go to Window Default Tray and make sure it says Show Tray, or click that Show Tray button and it'll show up over here. Now you want to make sure that you have the Soften Edges tab open, and then if this is graying out like it is now, you want to make sure that you have your edges and faces selected. So just like this, I have a 0 degree angle between normals for my softening, and that basically unsoftens my shape. Now what I'm going to do here is I'm going to make a few more copies. So just copy to here, multiplication symbol, the asterisk times 3, so that I have a few different instances, and we're just going to go through what the different options of softened edges are. So if I select all of these edges and I go all the way to 180 degrees, you can see I get a really nice shape. Actually, maybe this will be a little bit more clear. I'm going to uncheck these two and go all the way up. So you can see I get a smooth shape. All the edges are smooth, but I still have faceting. Basically, what's happening there is I get sort of like a disco ball. So the edges are hidden, but the shapes aren't, or the edges aren't blending between each other. So if I select this and I do the 180 degrees, but I check smooth normals, you can see I get that smoothing between the edges, which helps give that more fluid feel. It feels less faceted. Now, if I select this last one and I do the same thing, but hit soften, go planar, it doesn't look like it did anything. So what I'm going to do is actually come back down and I'm going to hit L for the line tool. And I'm just going to draw some random lines on this face here. Now, this is basically, just make sure that I connect to the edges so that I'm 100% sure that I'm making coplanar lines. So these lines are all coplanar. These, I don't know, however many lines are in here. These are all drawn on that face. So what happens if I have lines like this and I select all of them, and I hit smooth normals, I get all those lines that I just drew, they don't get hidden. So if you want to hide something like that, if for whatever reason you have those extra straight lines, you just hit soften, go planar, and that will get rid of them there. So hopefully this video helped. If you liked it, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.